Thank you for letting me know. We'll start that again, shall we? The mic should be back on now. It looks like I've got some levels. Anyway, I'll start again. Rewind that. How's it going, everyone? Welcome to episode 39 of the Phoenix Studios live show here in the UK, the home of rock and roll. Good to see that Reviver Night is back. Hope you've had a nice relaxing stint away. There you go. You would think after 39 episodes I knew how to turn my mic on. So yeah, good to have you back, man. Hope you've been doing good. Good to see you. Silk's here. Hey, man. Invader's been here since about 6 o'clock. I had a quick chat with him. And Lena's here as well, of course. So yeah, good to see all you guys. I know I have one bug in terms of my alert sounds aren't working properly. I don't know why. Worked a couple of weeks ago, but this is what happens when you have a week off. Things stop working. Anyway, yeah, good to see you, man. Yeah, good to see you. All right. Let's kick off the show. Alright, I do not know what is happening with the alerts. Reviver's trying his best to do flames and stuff. I think it's working. Let's try that again. There we go. It works, but it only works on certain screens. Basically. A bit of lag there. Anyway. So, of course, 2 weeks away, we're going to have some little technical bits and bobs happening. But hey... I think, Reviver, I think you could probably do the Bolt one now, unless I haven't set you up. I'm pretty sure I have set you up. Ghost Monkey's here as well. Hey, man. Rock on. Good to see you. Let's see. Let me just check. Reviver's got enough points. Yeah, he does. Awesome. But we have no sound. I've been having some problems with my sound, for sure. But hey, at least we still got the effects. That's something. Rightio. Okay. So let me see. What am I doing? It's this thing. You're 2 weeks away. You've got no clue what's going on. You're like, I'm not sure what I'm doing. Right. Let's get into the news because that's what we usually do first. Hey, Reviver Night subscribe. Nice, man. Rock on. Cheers. Sorry, no alert sounds, but hey, at least we've got chaos on the screen. No problem. God, I'm so rusty. I haven't done this in ages. Okay, let's get into the news before I stuff everything up. All right, so the news for today. Let's see. So with Reviver Night resubscribing, here we go. So 3 month subscribers. I'm not sure if you're 3 or 4 months now, man. I've completely lost track. So Reviver and Nick. 3 month subscribers. Thanks very much to you guys for keeping the stream going. Really appreciative. 4 months. Okay, so I will add you to the next slide next week. So you are 4 month subscriber. It's really hard to keep track, man. There's no way of keeping track. I don't know how people keep track, but hey, maybe there's a special way. Hey, Nick's here. Yeah. Nick, are you a 3 or 4 month subscriber as well? I've lost track, man. I can't work out. There's no way of telling who's who and what's what and how many months people have subscribed for. It's really hard to tell. So, yeah. You guys. Awesome. Great. So, next up, we've got 4 month subscribers where we should actually have Reviver Night in this group as well. We've got Ghost Monkey. We've got That Seeker. And we've got Frank as well. Our 4 month subscribers. Thank you so much, guys. Again, truly appreciate all the support you've been giving me over the last few months since the stream started. I mean, it's incredible. I really appreciate it. And then the last little slide we have is for our 5 month subscriber. And currently Hybrid is the only 5 month subscriber that I'm aware of. I apologize if anyone else is a 5 month subscriber and I don't know about it. So yeah, so thanks so much, guys. And thanks to everybody. Even if you aren't a subscriber, thank you for tuning in week on week. I really appreciate it. And yeah, you guys keep me going week on week. And hey, you keep the chat going as well in the Discord. So I really appreciate it. Cheers, dude. Guys, really awesome. Okay. Our back catalogue is now completely up to date. I spent God knows how much time. I think I must have uploaded about 5 new episodes. So as always, guys, you can check it out on YouTube. and watch the previous episodes there. Everything is free. I don't offer anything. I'm not like asking people to pay for these or anything like that. So yeah, everything's free. Feel free to have a look at them. I try my best to describe each episode. But yeah, we're all up to date, including the 38th episode, which was our Halloween special, which was awesome. So yeah, and on that note, we're starting to look at potentially doing a different time next week. I mentioned this on the Discord earlier. You guys probably know about it already. Effectively, I'm trying to work out the best time so that Frank can tune in and so that I have a little bit of extra time to prepare things week on week. And I'm going to try and stream on Thursday at 8 next week, and we'll see what happens. I know it's Thanksgiving over there, so I'm well aware that Nick and Ghost Monkey will be full of turkey and probably sleeping on the sofa watching some TV or something. That's no problem whatsoever. So yeah, guys, we're going to try Thursday next week, 8 p.m. See how it goes. I'm not sure if we'll stick to it, but we're going to try. Hopefully Frank can tune in around that time. He seemed to be pretty keen, so all good. And then the next little update, we have a new reward for our embers. So we actually have a new reward, and it's taken me a little bit of time to think of this one because I was trying to think of what could a 10,000 ember reward be, and it kind of hit me in the face, literally. And I thought it might be quite fun because we had so much fun with it at Halloween. So 10,000 embers, you will summon Skullface or Skeletor, as you know him. So I will dress up with my skull and my Skeletor outfit and parade around on stream because it was so much fun last time on the Halloween stream. I thought, hey, let's bring that in as a reward for 10,000 embers. So you'll get the mask. I put the mask on and the outfit here. I have my outfit ready whenever needs be. Fun times. And I don't actually have a slide for this, but while I'm here, I'll remember. We have a new little mascot for the stream. My dad was kind enough to actually buy me this from the US and brought it back from the US. So this is our new little mascot. Here's the little Eddie Trooper mascot, which I'm going to put in the background somewhere. So he was kind enough to buy that for me a couple of months ago, and I kept saying I'm going to put it on the stream and completely forgot every single time, but he's pretty cool. His little head bobs around. So yeah, cheers, Dad. Appreciate that. Yeah, so he's our new little mascot, and hey, maybe we can name him other than Eddie. Maybe we could name him something different. I don't know, Jeff, Bob, whatever you want to call him. So yeah, so he might just stay in the background for now. We'll put him there. There we go. He's in the background watching over things. Nice. Yeah, cool. So that's kind of most of the news for today. So our 10,000 ember reward is Skullface. So you can summon Skeletor effectively for 10,000 embers. I vote for Cody as the name. Hey, that's such an American name. Ghost Monkey. Cody is such an American name, man. Greggy. Oh, maybe. Who knows? Maybe we'll do a vote on it. Who knows? So in terms of our embers leaderboard, of course, Nick is still at the top, reaching almost 10,000 embers. And I believe that Reviver is not too far behind him. But I do believe that Nick has kind of steamed ahead the last few weeks for sure. So our album of the week, and this is kind of the theme of the stream in some ways. So the album of the week this week, I've had some great recommendations from Frank this week, and I'll be putting those in probably over the next few streams. But this one is definitely one I've been kind of wanting to feature for a while. I was just waiting for the right moment. So the album of the week is Queen, A Night at the Opera, and the artist is Freddie Mercury, would you believe, and the art director, David Costa. So having done a bit of research into this, I mean, this is an absolutely classic album, guys. This one's got Bohemian Rhapsody on it, which is like obviously one of the biggest rock anthems of all time. So unbelievably, Freddie Mercury actually designed the original emblem, the original kind of lion and stuff. I just won 2,200 embers. That's insane, man. That's insane. Can't believe it. That's crazy. So Freddie Mercury designed this along with David Costa. And yeah, let's get right into it. Let me just pull up the right tab for this. There we go. So yeah, so as I was saying, you know, one of the most iconic albums ever, Night of the Opera. It's got Bohemian Rhapsody on it. And there's not a whole lot else to say, really, apart from it is one of those albums that's just absolutely legendary. And if you don't know about it, definitely look it up, because there's quite a bit of controversy around it. Certainly if you've seen the film. So, for example, Bohemian Rhapsody not being released as a single initially, and the record company not wanting to release it because it was too crazy. So I would definitely recommend you guys go and see the Queen film, Bohemian Rhapsody, that's out at the cinema currently. I don't know how much longer it's on. I saw it last week. It was freaking awesome. So yeah, that's kind of inspired me the last week or so to actually create something around that. So I'll show you guys in a minute what I'm working on. So in terms of who created it, we've got, so this is actually a print, so you can see it a bit closer. You can kind of see the little motif going on here, the little emblem. This is actually a phoenix in the background, which I didn't know about. And I believe it represents each of the zodiac signs of the band members. So this is like the four zodiac signs, and then there's a phoenix in the background, kind of quite symbolic. And in terms of like who art directed it, it's this guy David Costa. This is his website. You can't really find out much information on there, if I'm honest, about the Queen stuff. There's a bunch of other stuff like Jimi Hendrix. It's quite an old school website, but you can kind of browse it. You can kind of see some of his work. And I'll be posting that on the Discord a bit later. But he's done some work for the Stones and a few other things as well. Even some stuff for Michael Jackson. So, yeah, so he's kind of worth checking out. But then I kind of did a bit more research and I found out that the Queen logo has been going for quite a while. So the Queen crest was designed by Freddie Mercury shortly before the release of the first album. Features the zodiac signs of all the four members. The two lions for Leo, for Deacon and Duncan. A crab for Cancer. Is it dead? I don't know, man. What are you talking about, Silk? I don't know. Are you not seeing what the stream or something? I don't know. And so, yeah. The crab is resting atop a queue with flames rising directly above it. I hope you guys can hear me. I don't know if the stream is conked out, but I'm hoping it's still going. And this kind of shows a progression of the logo over the years. The Twitch machine got unplugged. I don't know what's going on for that there, man. Give it a refresh. So Vader, he was the designer as well. And here on this site, you can actually see kind of a kind of progression of how the logo changed over time. So if you look here, this is like an ink sketch. I don't know, I'm just pointed at the screen. A-okay for everybody else. Text logo is pretty awesome. Yeah, man, I quite like that. And this shows kind of like the evolution of the logo. So there you go, Night at the Opera. Art directed by David Costa, I believe. And you can see how it really changes over the years. Like, and look at this. It's almost like some sort of cartoon Discworld Terry Pratchett kind of vibe going on here on the bottom left. That is epic. I don't know what album that's from, but that's pretty damn epic. And then this is, I think, the kind of more recent version of the logo. It looks like a vector version. But that's pretty awesome. I love that. So yeah, I mean, I didn't realize Freddie Mercury was the designer of the logo as well. I mean, that's pretty insane to me. Like, he was such a great artist in every aspect, you know, singer, songwriter, musician, and also an artist. I mean, it's crazy, absolutely crazy. And that kind of brings me. No, I've never seen some of them either. And what I'll do is I'll actually, you know what, while I'm at it, I'll post that in the Discord so you guys can see it. I'll chuck it in inspiration. There we go. That's an inspiration. You guys can check it out later. There you go. Call your mascot Freddy. There's a good idea. That's a good idea. Call him Eddie Freddy. Ready Freddy or something like that. Hey, Mr. Triple. Rock on, man. Thanks for tuning in. Appreciate it. So yeah, so we've just been going through the Queen logo, man. Like basically, Queen is album of the week. Bohemian Rhapsody, A Night at the Opera, which has got Bohemian Rhapsody on it, and we've just been going through some of the Queen logos from over the years, which are quite incredible, really awesome stuff. And so this is the poster for Bohemian Rhapsody, the movie. And what I thought I would do over the last week, basically I got super inspired seeing the movie, and I thought, well, I really would like to create a poster that's a tribute to Freddie and put it out there. Basically, there isn't really much sort of fan, there aren't many fan posters out there. The only one I've kind of spotted is this one, which for me, it's fairly simple and kind of vector, and it doesn't really, for me, it doesn't really evoke the I don't know, it doesn't seem to evoke all like the passion that's in the movie. So, whereas the official poster really does a good job of that. So I thought, well, I'll start creating my own one. So let's go to the headliner for today. And what we're going to be doing is I'm going to be carrying on with my poster, which I started it was a while ago. It must have been about 4 or 5 days ago. So here you go. So basically, the style is very, very different to what I usually create. The style is much more kind of, I suppose, vector looking, but I'm creating this completely within Sketch. I'm not doing any kind of vector work or tracing or anything like that. And my art process has started to evolve quite a bit. So you can see like the face is mostly done. It still needs some work, but the rest of the body kind of needs a lot of work, a lot of shading and stuff. And my idea is to kind of basically take that and then apply a bit of a kind of a rough kind of tone to it. A bit more texture, I think, is probably what, I don't want it to look too shiny. But I'm trying to get influenced by the color scheme of the poster, which is purple and kind of gold. So this still has a lot of work to get put into it, but you can kind of see where I'm going with it. Cheers, guys. Appreciate it. Reviver and Vader. Rock on. Appreciate it. Yeah, I've never done a poster before. This is the first poster I've ever done. To give you an idea of the concept behind it. So there's a quote in the movie and the quote is like, I'm going to punch a hole in the sky. We're going to punch a hole in the sky is the quote from the movie. It's quite a famous quote from him in terms of he says basically they're about to play Wembley at Live Aid, and he says we're going to punch a hole right through the roof of Wembley, and it's like, and then I think Brian May says something like, oh, it's, you know, it's actually got an open roof, and he's like, right, but we'll punch a hole right through the sky, and that kind of stuck with me, that quote. So I was trying to think of a concept for the poster, and I just couldn't think of anything. And then that quote kind of reminded me, oh yeah, he said that. So I tried to find some reference of him punching the sky, but it was really difficult to actually find something. So I kind of comped it together a bit, and then did a little mock-up with like a galaxy in Photoshop, like a galaxy black and white, and tried to overlay the type. And what I want to try and do is kind of get the O kind of cracking, so it looks like he's punching through the O. It's kind of my concept for the poster. And hoping to kind of do more to it and kind of really bring it to life. But the style, like I say, is super different to what I'm used to doing. I got very, very inspired by a lot of poster work that I saw out there, a lot of Blade Runner poster work I've been looking at, because the color scheme's kind of similar with the purples and stuff. So trying to make it look a bit more like that and more defined, so the shading is not as kind of airbrushed as my previous stuff. And I think I'm quite excited by this, because this style, I'm really digging this style. Cheers, Vader. Like you were saying, digging the comic book style. When I put the overlay on the top, it probably won't be too comic booky, but I just feel like I wanted to kind of like try something different to what I'm used to. It's kind of going, it's going somewhere, that's for sure. Even like this kind of shading where I'm putting in these little flicks, this is something new that I'm playing around with. I've been trying to, I asked you guys sometime this week about style and how that does that evolve, or is it something you kind of just kind of learn as you're going along, or is it something intended? With this piece, I actually intended to try and find a style that I could say, right, well, that is my style. Do you know what I mean? And that's what I'm trying to work out. So I'm wondering if these flicks, and I'm sure I've seen other people do them, but I'm wondering if they do them in the same way. Because in some ways, these flicks kind of represent a bunch of things. So they kind of look like flames in some ways, in my opinion. They also look a bit like feathers. And I was thinking feathers and flames, phoenix, you know, it kind of works. It kind of goes together. So I'm thinking, like, is this like going to be kind of a signature thing that I do on all my pieces, where I kind of do these kind of flamey looking or feathery looking little shadows and stuff. So I'm still playing with it. I don't know if I'm going to keep them, but I really kind of am digging doing that. And I had to kind of, I guess, do a bit of work to actually get that working right. And I know Lena was kind of helping me with a brush and stuff. In the end, I ended up kind of tweaking a few other brushes. And yeah, it's a lot simpler to do than previous. Like before, I really struggled with Sketch to actually make these kind of nice lines. But yeah, we're getting to it. Anyway, big massive overload of information for you guys. I've been basically keeping this all in till today because I've had this all in my head. So yeah, I appreciate your support. And hey, let's get into it. So huge improvement over your previous Maiden designs. Yeah, man. I mean, those were really quick designs. This is a lot more polished, and I'm really happy with where it's going. So we're going to carry on a bit with that, and try and get some of these shadows looking correct on the arm and stuff. I've literally just blocked them in very quickly. You can see my little sketch there. I mean, the likeness, I'm really happy with the likeness. Took me a little bit of time to get it, but I got the likeness in the end. Yeah. Nick Culbertson, own it. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of what I'm thinking, man. It's like, if I put my stuff out there, somebody looked at it, if you look at it, there aren't any, like, distinguishing hallmarks, I would say, like, saying, like James has got his 80s thing, and he always uses, like, very similar color palette, very similar kind of compositions, and you just know it's him who's created it. That's kind of where he's got to, and I want to kind of achieve a similar thing where people will say, oh, yeah, that's Phoenix Studios, I can recognize it. So I'm trying to kind of build that and try and just get it to that kind of standard. I leveled up. Oh, cheers, dude. I appreciate it. I'm hoping that I can continue leveling up because there's still a lot of work to go into this. Crazy amount of work. I mean, even just to get these colors looking correct took me quite a while because it's such a huge overhaul of my process. And yeah, it's been fun this last week. It's also been very not stressful, but kind of frustrating, because I wanted to achieve that kind of look, and it wasn't coming together as quickly as I wanted. So I'm still working out the kinks to this process, still trying to work out what I'm doing with it, and still trying to kind of get it looking smooth. And yeah, it's going to be a learning curve. It's a real learning curve for sure. Like, even, like, getting these shapes to look smooth, because this isn't a vector program, as you guys know, it's kind of like a bit of trial and error to kind of get everything looking smooth. So I tend to kind of do that and then kind of keep refining it. To be honest, I've seen this style done ad nauseum all over the internet. It's not unique to anyone else, and you shouldn't feel unsure using it. Yeah, no, I mean, it's kind of like, I know it's not unique, but it's kind of like, for me, there's like certain traits that you could say are a certain artist, and that's what I'm trying to kind of get to the point where, you know, I'm owning a particular style and then kind of refining it so like certain tweaks are added in, and then I can say, right, well, that's more my style. So, because I've seen this kind of stuff before, man, as well. Like, I've seen this kind of like comic-y line effect used a fair bit, but I'm wondering, How many times do you see it with kind of like quite sort of intense glows and things like that? More of an 80s kind of style. So I'm trying to mix kind of two styles together, I think, is what I'm trying to do. I could also be talking out my ass. I don't know. Who knows? Right. Yeah, and I mean, I've experimented with this style before with the Rock Duos project that I put out. I kind of experimented with it. I didn't really like the style, but I never tried mixing my old style and this style together, which is kind of what I've been doing with this. So it's like, yes, there are shapes, but there's also a lot of glows, and kind of like the glows are kind of airbrushed in a way, which is not something I've tried before. But we'll see. We'll see what happens. Yeah, add your own signature. Yeah, that's right, man. It's like, yes, there's a lot of people doing that style, but by adding certain elements to it, then does it become your style? It's a bit like that that Tracy Ching. I've been kind of like sort of following her stuff, looking at her stuff for inspiration. And the fact that she uses, you know, her style is like, it's kind of like a common style, but she has like those dotted lines that kind of make it her own. That dotted detail work kind of makes it hers. So I was thinking about it. I was like, well, what that makes her style hers. So what makes my style mine? You know what I mean? Like, I'm trying to work out the little things that I do that might make it my own somehow. I don't know. But I think it's going to be an evolving thing, like you guys were saying. Definitely an evolving thing, because I don't think this is going to be the final kind of iteration of this style by any means. I'm sure it's going to evolve over time, but this is the first time I'm kind of really trying it. Yeah, crosshatch, that's the one. But it's kind of a dotted crosshatch, which is quite different from what I can see. And these shadows, I mean, yeah, this needs a lot of work, because ultimately, what I've found is doing it this way, it's very easy to block things in, but then refining it after is a bit of a pain. So I'm looking forward to when Gemini comes out and I can actually start just drawing vectors with a pen tool. It'll be a lot easier to do this kind of style. Yeah, and I'm enjoying working with this process, that's for sure. So, let's see. So, 7:35. Right. I'm wondering what... the hair is something... This is actually how it started with the hair. And I was just playing about with this kind of line effect. And it was very rough. So, I'm actually thinking maybe I will redo the highlights on the hair. That's kind of something I've been thinking of doing. So, let's have a little go now, actually. Because that might be more interesting than me doing shading. Let's see. Okay, I wonder if my layer's confused now. Can I add a new layer? No, I can't. Bugger. Okay, let's delete some things. I can delete that. Okay. New layer. New layer. All right. Hide that. Bring these down a bit. So how are you guys anyway? There's been a lot of talk on the Discord the last few days. Been really cool seeing what you guys have been up to. Okay, I'll hide that for now. See, these might be a little bit more refined. Yeah, so Lena sent me like a triangle brush, and I tried to use it in Sketch, and it just wouldn't work. It was like, it looked terrible. I'm sure it looks much better in Photoshop, but in Sketch, it just doesn't work. You have to, like, there's loads of extra controls that you need to put in. So that's something I've been kind of battling with. Have I done it at the wrong angle? Okay. I have actually done it at the wrong angle. Ugh, you idiot. Let's try that again. Ear looks too detailed, busy to me. Yes, I know. I'm not happy with the ear either myself. There's a lot going on, and I'm trying to make it simpler. Hair details look good as is. Oh, okay. Well, I just feel like it's a bit messy. versus like this down here on the bottom left. I feel like the hair is a bit messy. Maybe it needs to be messy. I don't know. From a distance, it looks quite good. But up close, it just looks a bit messy for me. That ear, though, yes, has been the bane of my life the last couple of days. I've been trying to get that right, and I haven't got it right still. It looks a bit too big, so I'm going to have to try and see if I can fix that at some point. So, yeah, I think it just needs to be a little bit less messy, I suppose. But maybe messy's good. We'll see. I do like how the hair highlights is layered. Ah, okay, yeah. Yeah, for sure. Like I say, this is a brand new process for me, guys, so I'm going to make a lot of mistakes. And I've been making a lot of mistakes, but I'm quite happy because I was not feeling, looking back on kind of like the work I've done the last year, I was not really feeling the direction everything was going. It just felt a bit kind of cartoony, I suppose is the word I would use. And that's cool, but I suppose if I'm going to try and do poster work and anything like that, then I need to have a little bit more of a refined kind of style up my sleeve. Yeah, I'm still getting the hang of these lines. That is not cool. Right, where did I put this? There we go. Let's try and... The size needs a bit bigger. I think I usually go about 60 or so. Yeah, I just want to make them a little bit less messy, because it was a bit messy. This is a weird one with this brush, is like sometimes it works great and sometimes it doesn't work very well. I think it depends on the angle that you're actually drawing on. Yeah, bizarre. Sometimes it works nicely. Check out the work of Nicky Barkler. Okay, yeah. I'll check him out later. Ah, it seems to be going in the same direction. Oh, okay. Okay, that's interesting. I mean, I love my... I do like my kind of bright colors and stuff. But I just want something a little bit more refined somehow. I can't explain it. Maybe it's just a taste thing over time that kind of changes. I think as well, you guys have kind of been influencing me quite a lot. So, hey Sniff, hey, how's it going, man? Good to see you. So today we're working on a Freddie Mercury poster, which I've started last week in my spare time, and kind of continuing today. Playing about with some hair and stuff. Yeah, it's definitely a little bit better. Maybe a little bit too rigid, but we'll see how it goes. So now I'm just working on some highlights and just trying to work out how it goes, really. Yeah, and at this stage, I mean, I'm still experimenting with this style quite a lot. It's not 100% perfect. Still something I'm working on. But it's fun, guy. I've actually... That's something... It's been quite fun experimenting with something quite new. Because I've kind of got a bit tired of all my pieces being quite similar. And I'm always using the same process to do them. So I thought... Let me try and challenge myself and do something a bit more hard-edged in terms of shadows and stuff and shading. It's quite a challenge to actually get it to look right. It's actually really challenging. But it's coming along. It's getting there. So that's a bonus. Let's see. So that's a little bit better. There's a bit more highlight there. Okay. Just want to try and get it a little bit smoother. I'm still kind of, like I say, working this one out. It's a little bit too straight. Let's add more of a curve to it. Okay, fair enough. I think as well, this kind of style will work a lot better for kind of heavy metal influenced things. Based on what I've been looking at and researching, this sort of style probably lends it much better to that kind of work. So I feel like this is a positive kind of step forward in style. Definitely for kind of my ambitions and stuff, it's definitely kind of the right change. I'm not saying I'm never going to go back to my other style, but for now, I feel like this is probably the right way to go. Yeah, something like that. Okay. Let's try and round this little corner off. So what I'm trying to do is I'm going to try and get this released next week is what I'm going to try and do. I've still got a bunch to do. I mean, I've got all the shading and stuff to do for the arms. I also want to do a little bit of a background somehow, with some lighting, and then at the top is going to be kind of a universe. So I need to actually get out my old school universe brushes or use some free galaxy photography, because there's loads of I don't know if you guys know this, but there's loads of like nebulas and stuff for free on Wikipedia. So I might use some of those. Yeah, Vader, do it. Yeah, man. Yeah, we're trying something completely new. So I haven't used galaxies and stuff for years, because I used to do that kind of stuff when I was first experimenting with Photoshop, just doing galaxies and experimenting with brushes and all this kind of stuff. So yeah, for sure. Yeah, Vader, you've really kind of inspired me in some ways with your posters and stuff, and seeing kind of where you were getting to with your posters and them looking really cool. So you've been a bit of an influence there, man, so I appreciate it. Yeah, so this is where I'm kind of trying to... The problem with this is I don't want it to look like hair. So it's kind of like... It's still something I'm learning. So it's like I would do something like that to kind of just get the kind of like extra shading. But it needs some tweaking. For now, we'll just do the shape very quickly. And like I say, once Gemini comes out, I'll be super happy, because I'll be able to mix vector with the with the airbrush and stuff. So that'll work very well for me, I'm hoping. Yeah, this is really rough. Jeez. Super rough. I'm hoping to get this done by next week. Next Wednesday or Thursday or something. Probably before the next stream. I really want it to go out there. As well, I was thinking, I think the movie's going to be wrapping up soon, in terms of like you won't be able to see it. So it's kind of like I want it done and dusted before the movie ends. Because otherwise, people probably forget about it. And if I had been clever about this, I could have done this weeks ago. But I was too busy having fun with Slash and all the rest of it. So yeah. And it's like a lot of this stuff, man. It's just trial and error. Like, this year, for me, has all been about trial and error. Literally trying to work out what it is I'm doing. Trying to work out a way of making things that I find that I'm like that I'm challenging myself with, but I still kind of feel comfortable doing. So yeah, man, this is a way out of my comfort zone, 100%. But I'm kind of enjoying it, kind of liking where it's going. Okay, set that back to normal. How are you guys doing anyway? You guys doing all good? like I was saying, the Discord's been pretty crazy, busy the last few days, which is great. I love the fact you guys are chatting and getting advice, and I'm getting advice as well from you guys, which is awesome. So yeah, awesome stuff. Okay, just block that in. Let's see how that looks. Hanging out in trial and error is fine. That's where you find techniques you like and those you hate. Yeah. Trial and error, experimentation is the only way to do it. This is it. It's like, when I tried to do this, and I have tried multiple times, I really didn't enjoy it that much. I think because I didn't have a process behind it that I enjoyed doing. Whereas now I'm actually like I'm really super happy with how the face has actually turned out, because I didn't actually think it would look that good. And it's not finished yet, but I'm super happy with how it's kind of going and the direction it's going, and it looks a lot slicker than my previous stuff. So it's definitely headed in the right direction, but it's taken me a while to kind of realize where things are going, 100%. Okay. Busy. Finally got to finish Fallout New Vegas. Oh, nice, man. Nice. I've not played any of the Fallout games, but I know about them. Yeah, I mean, I saw you, I saw Mr. Triple, I saw you posted your little 76, was it 76 Vegas, 76 Fallout, which is a new game or something? Pretty sure it's a new game. Can't be certain, but yeah. Okay, so that's kind of like the rough blocks, I suppose you could call them. And then if I go on my darks, yeah, okay. I'll just rough these in. The hardest part, actually, of this whole thing, when I was doing the face, the hardest part... So what happened was I started with grayscale, but then converting grayscale to color is super tricky, because you easily can make it look washed out. And that's why I've always stayed away from this style, because I don't want it looking washed out. I want it really bright and colorful. So I had to kind of like do two things at once and do like grayscale and then test color and then grayscale and then test color until I was quite happy with it. But it took a several goes to actually get it looking right and the color combinations to really pop. So it's been a lot of trial and error, like I was saying. it's the 76th title in the Fallout series. Oh, right. Really? I didn't know that. That's crazy. Awesome. Right, okay, so I'm going to stop babbling on. Put the right layer. Haven't got the right layer. There we go. Put the right layer? Where have I put it? See, this is the thing, I'm getting confused now. That's my other layer. Huh? Oh, that's my sketch layer. So where's it gone? Huh? Well, it's definitely on. Is it that one? Oh, yeah, we go. Okay. I did it right all along. Okay. So I think based on my little sketch, layer. Where's my little sketch gone? There we go. I should really name my layers. But... So I want that to be a lot darker. There we go. Block that in. Guess that would be darker. That's probably going to be dark there. I'm trying to guess where my shadows are. Way ahead of kind of doing them. Which is, I'm learning kind of as I go to block in these colors early, so I know what I'm doing. And it's kind of like, this is a lot better than me trying to guess where things are. So I'm trying to get that done up front and not necessarily be perfect about it. I don't even know if that's gonna be like that. I don't know. I might have to go back and check my reference a bit more. Possibly not. This is probably going to be quite dark. That's going to be super dark around there for sure. Who was your companion in New Vegas? I went with Cass for the most part. And of course, Rex. I have no idea what you guys are talking about. But it's cool, man. It's cool. No worries. And I get the feeling that maybe there might be a little bit of shadow. And probably there as well. Still working all these out. Okay. You guys are talking about gaming. Speaking of which, we haven't had a gaming stream in a while. I suppose I need to get back to that at some point. That's something I need to be doing. Maybe I'll do a bit more shading there. I guess there would be a shadow there. I'm just guessing here. Might not be correct. We'll have to see how we go. And probably there as well. Right. Whoops, put a dot on his head. My bad. Actually, I need to be a bit careful with the shadow that I'm putting in. I need to be a bit careful that it don't go over his face. That's kind of what I'm worried about. Don't think I went over his face. Phew. Don't think I did. Lost my layer again. Really need to name these layers. There it is. Nope, not that one. Okay, it is that one. Okay. I think we're good. Cool. Alright, 528. So I think what I will do, guys, I'll carry on with this for a couple of minutes, and then we'll leave it as it is, probably. There's so much work that I need to do on this. I mean, it's going to take me a lot more time to get it to the level where I want it to be at. Well, that's kind of creepy. Look at that. Ooh, that's pretty damn creepy. Seeing it without line work. And that's another thing I've been wrestling with is, should I be keeping my line work in there, or should I be just keeping it as just straight paint? You know, just having no line work at all. Something I've been wrestling with for a while is, do I just keep the line work in there or just take it out at the end and just smooth everything up? Kind of looks cool. But, yeah, I don't know, man. It's something that probably evolve over time. But for now, I'm keeping the line work in, I think. I like the line work. I like doing line work. So that's something I'm going to be doing. You like the lines, Nick. Okay, cool, man. Nice. Awesome. So, I mean, there's other stuff I need to add as well. Like, I need to add some shading on his teeth, the tongue, more texture. I need to fix this ear, which has been the bugbear of my week so far. And yeah, just all the rest of the shading in general. So I'm looking forward to it when it's going to be done. But I think it's going to take me a lot more time. Cool. You say keep the lines too, man. Awesome. Cheers, Reviver. Rock on. Okay, so I think for now, We'll probably keep it as it is there for now, because I'm gonna have to spend ages on this. So we'll keep it like that. But you guys get a little sneak peek of what I'm working on. I'm enjoying where it's going, and it's great to kind of share with you guys the process I'm going through now of actually making this and discovering new ways of doing things. So that's our little headliner for today. A bit of Freddie Mercury, a little bit of a tribute piece to Freddie Mercury. Going to try and put it out there next week, guys. Fingers crossed, and I'm looking forward to it being all finished, having a galaxy at the top and nice typography and all the rest of it. You guys know the score. So that's our little headliner for today. Awesome. good to share with you guys. So next up, I think what we'll do is we will do a bit of Rock Who coming up very shortly. But I think I'm going to have a little bit of a break first. And I will see you guys in about 5 minutes. You know the score. See you in about five.
Hey!
right, we are back from our little intermission there, as we always have during the show. Might come up with some new ones, hopefully soon. If I get some more footage together from different gigs and stuff, we'll see how we go. Vader, jumping up and down with the guitar. Don't know why, but I find it cringy. I think it depends on who's jumping up and down, because sometimes it looks really cool. That's just my opinion. So yeah, guys, so let's get into Rock Who for today. Let me find my Rock Who slide. There we go. Of course, because since our Halloween stream, I've had to go back through every single slide and update it back to how it was. So that was another task I had to do today without remembering. That was fun. So yeah, so Rock Who, guys. So who's up for a little game of Rock Who? I've got a few things to draw today. I've got it all set up, all ready to go. Nice. Okay, that's working good. It would help if my notes were open, because they're not open at the moment. There we go. Alright, so we've got four or five different things. Rock Who. Let's see how we go. Okay. Right, I forgot to turn my phone off, because my phone is like constantly buzzing up with alerts. I'll just turn that off. Done. Right, let's go. Tom Morello jumped up and down. I guess it's fine. If Tom Morello jumped up and down, I guess it's fine. Oh, come on, man. It's Tom Morello. I mean, freaking hell, man. He is an absolute legend. So, that's okay. He can, but imagine Tony Iommi. That would be quite funny, to be fair. That's a good point. All right, so, Rock Who. Let's get into this. Cool. So the first one, I think most of these are bands today because I haven't had a whole lot of time to prepare these. So, all right, let's get going. Oops. No. What's going on there? If anyone's going to guess this one. Not to confuse things. Let's see if anyone will get this one. I don't know if anyone will get this one, but hopefully somebody will. Let's see. Any guesses, anyone? Any guesses? Any guesses? I'm trying to think of another way of drawing this, but I can't think of another way of drawing it. So that's one clue, I guess. I don't know if I can draw this another way. Can I draw this another way? Can I draw it another way? I don't think I can. Any guesses? Anyone at all? No guesses. Okay. Oh, look at that, Nick. Got it. Green Day. Well done, sir. I was thinking I'd have to come back to that one, but okay. Yeah, you got it. Well done. So Nick is still in front. Good one, man. Come on, Reviver. You need to get back in the swing of things. Come on. Somebody's got to challenge Nick. All right. Another band name. Let's see. You're Rusty. I see. I don't know if this is one word or two words. Okay. So this band has got four words. Sorry, guys. Thinking about bands related to December. That's why I didn't put November, because I thought somebody would say November Rain. That's what I was thinking. Oh, look at that. Nick got it again. Oh, I didn't even have time to finish it. There we go. Yes, Queens of the Stone Age. That's the one. Look at that. Nick in front straight away. Is it one word or is it five words? So I thought, is it five words? Oh, it is five words. Oh, my bad, guys. Sorry about that. It is indeed five words. I thought Stone Age was one word. See, I should have gone back to school. All right, so Nick got that one. That's two words. You know what? Revive, I'll give you a point for giving me the right spelling. Definitely. Okay. Cool. Okay. Let's see. Okay. This is another band. All right. One word. Yeah, man. Definitely settle for it because I didn't know it was five words. So that's fair enough. Oops. This is a UK band. I saw them a few years ago. They're really cool. No, almost. Almost UK band. Very similar. Very similar. Another word. Ah, Ghost Monkey got it. Ah, I give Reviver half a point for that one because he was very close. Is indeed garbage. Dustbin. It's garbage. Damn it. You see, you're rusty, man. Rusty. Okay. This one, I wonder if anyone's going to get. It's a band who I saw a few years ago at a festival. Were absolutely insane. To give you an idea. Oops. My best way of illustrating this. Crybaby, no, but one word in there. This band, Kid Rock, no. No. Laugh Man. I don't know how else to express it. Basically, so Reviver, you've got so I'll give you one word. So the first word is baby. So Reviver's got one word so far, and this is the second word. Basically, you can kind of guess probably what it's referring to. God, that's a demonic. Baby possessed. No, that's only if I do this. Then then he's possessed. I don't know how else to draw it, guys. But yeah, it's a Japanese band. You guys probably don't know the band. It's a Japanese band. It's an all-female band. You may have to look it up. I don't know. You might not know the band. Why is your baby so angry? Because it's a metalhead. That's why. did Nick get the right answer? Baby metal. Oh, okay. Oh, God. Nick got it ages ago. My bad. Sorry, guys. I didn't even see it. The chat went so fast. Nick got it. It's baby metal. Sorry, Nick. I didn't see your comments. Nick 3. Okay. Right. Let's get another one in. So those were the four I had prepared. I'm going to see if I can scroll through my list of other stuff and see if I can find something I haven't done before. Okay, let's try this one. Another band name. Look at Nick with his shades on. Somebody needs to take him down. mind you, Nick, you're going to be full of turkey next week, so I don't know if you'll be capable of playing next week because you'll be full of turkey. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to have to try and draw this. Okay, let's try and draw this. Okay. This is a one-word band, and it's this I'm referring to. I don't know how else to illustrate it, really. Not the easiest thing to illustrate. Not another demonic baby, please. Okay, I'll put one in. There you go. some of us have to sleep. Okay, dude, no worries. Sorry about that. But yeah, I'm referring to this, whatever this is. I'm trying to think of another way to draw it, but I can't think of anything. Can't think of anything off the top of my head. Blur, well done, Vader, got it. Yeah, Blur. It's an English rock band from the 90s. Well done, sir. So Vader got that one. Nice one. Cool. Right, we'll have one more. And then we'll leave it at that for today for Roku. Cool, cool. All right. Go fast. Nice one. Woohoo. All right. Let's see what else I can do. I think I've done that one before. Ooh, we could try this one. Artist slash band. So that's one person, not just like a group or whatever. What am I doing? Don't know what I'm doing. Some Halloween leftovers here. I'm probably going to give you more nightmares here, Vader, I'm afraid. Oasis is more than Blur. I kind of agree. I'm gonna try my best to draw this, but I don't know if I can get this in the time. So this is the second word, basically. Freddie Mercury. No, that would be an insult. I wouldn't be drawing him like that. Possessed gingerbread man. Rob Zombie, Mr. Triple got it. Well done, sir. Rob Zombie. I was trying my best to draw a zombie, but epically failed. Because I got a gingerbread man who was possessed. Okay, so Ghost Monkey 2. All right. Let's have a look at our points then for this week. So we've got Nick. So we've got Vader coming in with 1. Ghost Monkey with 2. Oh, sorry, Reviver Knight 1.5. Ghost Monkey with 2. And Nick with 3. There we go. Awesome. Should we tell Phoenix that Halloween was 2 weeks ago? Well, I did do a bunch of different illustrations or Rockus or whatever for Halloween, and I was trying to find some last minute things to illustrate, and Rob Zombie was on my list from Halloween, but we didn't put him in Roku. We did him as album of the week. So there we go. That's my explanation. It got a bit dark there. Yeah, sorry guys. Maybe a little bit dark. So let's add our embers now to our fortunate and excellent participants. Let's have a look. Just logging in now. My second point is Mr. Triple, but I will still take it. My second point is Mr. Triple, but I'm... Huh? Oh, I'm confused now. I'm literally just staring at the screen going, huh? Okay, I'm confused. Did I add the wrong point to the wrong person, maybe? I had 1 point. Oh, Mr. Triple. Yes, of course. Of course. My bad, sir. I will add you in. Add you in right now. 1 point. Okay. There you go, you see. I snuck you in. Mr. Triple, 1 point. Good stuff. All right. Let's have a look at our leaderboard. If I can get into the right part of this thing. Overlays, loyalty, manage users, points, what, embers. Oh, Nick's on 10,000 embers now. Look at that. 10,094. Reviver, 7,900 now. So let's add our points. So Mr. Triple got 250 to all our runners-up. Okay. 250 embers. 250. There we go. And we got, who else we got? We got Vader with 1, Ghost Monkey, and Reviver. Okay. Vader. Vader's third at the moment. Well done. Okay, 6,000 numbers of Vader. Ghost Monkey, 250. Save 250, and who else? Reviver, that was it. Reviver. Reviver. Reviver, where are you? Oh, you're second, aren't you? Of course. Save adjustment. And then Nick with 500 embers. There we go. So let's look at our leaderboard. So Nick in number 1, 10,500 embers. Viva number 2, 8,000 embers. Vader number 3, 6,300 embers. Ghost Monkey number 4, 3,700. So there's quite a gap between Ghost Monkey and Vader at the moment. And quite a gap again between Vader and Reviver. That's interesting. And yeah, guys. So I'm on there as well with 2,000 embers. I'm not sure how. Maybe I'll award that to a lucky person. Can have my embers. I'm not using them. Mr. Triple, I'm still recovering from all the embers I gambled away. Oh, wow, man, yeah. That's the nature of the beast, unfortunately. Nature of the beast. So that was our Roku for today. Awesome. So looking at our lineup, what we'll do now is we'll do a bit of Showtime, bit of Riff, and then we'll do our Encore. Is that how I usually do it? I'm not sure. Maybe we'll do Riff now and then Showtime. And I'm not sure, actually. I can't remember which way around I do it. Okay, never mind. Let's see. Let me think. Maybe a bit of guitar. Maybe a bit of guitar now, I suppose. Some people are in the chat, so let's do Riff, and we'll do Showtime after. Let's do that. Right, now I have the fun task of hooking up my camera, which earlier wasn't really working very well. So we'll see what happens with that. Let's give it a go. Okay, I had to reboot my phone and all kinds for it to kind of pick it up. And it did work. We will see if it works now. If not, then we'll try something different. Quick time. New movie recording. Ah, now I remember what I did last time. So let me change this. Let me get rid of this. Sorry guys, bear with me a second. Okay, let me turn it off here. Because is that why it wasn't working? Let's see. I get points for being early. You do indeed, sir. I'll add, I'll give you an extra 100 embers right now while I'm at it. There you go. An extra 100 embers for Vader for being early. There we go, sir. So you're on 6,484. Good man. Right, quick time. Where are you, little bugger? Come on, where are you? Movie recording. Phone. I do wish there was a more streamlined way of doing this. I keep saying it every time, but there isn't. Because Apple and all the rest of it. Do I get any for being late? No, you get minus 100. Not really. Right, let's see if I can get the camera on and working. Is this working? I hope it's working. We'll soon see. Put that away for now, because that's all good. It seems okay. That's good news. Put my keyboard there for now. And let's move this so we can see Eddie in the background. There we go. That's cool. You only show up for the embers. Oh, man. I'm gutted now. All right. Is the guitar working? Let's see. Nope. Not so far. I know why. Okay. No, I don't know why. Let's see. Definitely on. Yeah, it's definitely working. Maybe I need to open up the app. Let's see. Well, maybe I need to reopen my guitar app. I will try that. Don't save. Sorry, gang. Just trying to get my my guitar app working properly, because right now it's not. Hopefully it'll work now. Let's see. Nothing. Zero. Zero. Well, that's really interesting. You guys hear me all right? Are we back in action? I think my guitar's working now. This is a real weird one. So OBS hung because I restarted the guitar app, so it decided to hang. Usual silliness. It's working. Okay, this is good. I assume you guys can hear the guitar. All good on the guitar, nice one. Cool, okay, let's get back into this then. At least that was a quick little intermission. Right, let's get into this. So I'll do my first little riff. Let's get the right tone on. Alright, so our first riff today. Let's see if you guys can guess the artist and the name of the song. Yeah, so Jimi Hendrix, what song is it? Let's see if you guys can guess. So 1 point for Revival already. If you can guess the song, man, you get some extra points. Let's see if you guys can get this one. Okay, great stuff, Reviver. Got it. Purple Haze. Awesome. Okay, let's see if you guys can get the next one. It is not T-Rex. I'm wondering actually if this song is actually in a different tuning, so it might not sound quite correct. Apologies. Hey, Reviver got it. Start Me Up, Rolling Stones. Well done, sir. Look at that. So Reviver is coming out in force on Riff today, 100%. So yeah, you're right, man. It's Rolling Stones, Start Me Up. And I think it is down-tuned by a half step, I'm pretty sure. That might be why it sounds slightly different. Nice one. Awesome. So let's do a couple more. Great stuff. So Reviver is killing it today. Blur Song 2, you're right, man. Great stuff. Good, good, good. Okay, so we've got one more today. And then we'll go into Showtime. So hopefully the stream will keep up. Right, so let's see. Let me turn this up a bit. Let's see if we can get that a little bit. Alright, so the next one, let me see if I remember it. Okay. Let's do it. Hey, Natural Mermaids here. Hey, how you doing? Yeah, Under Pressure. Nice one, Reviver. Radio Gaga by Queen. Sorry, Natural Mermaid. No, it was Under Pressure. They all sound kind of similar, a little bit here and there. But yeah, it was Under Pressure. Really enjoyed that little riff. Tricky little riff, but got it in the end. So Reviver is completely and utterly the winner of Riff today. My word, every single one, man. I think a complete whitewash. So I think maybe we'll give you a few extra embers for that, man. Really well done. Shame about the stream kind of crashing halfway through, but never mind. We got there in the end. I don't know what happened with it, but anyway. So yeah, great stuff, man. Awesome. Awesome stuff. All right, so that's Riff for today. Great stuff. Nice. Hopefully it doesn't crash when I close that. Okay. Let's get into our Showtime now. Oh, guitar song. Okay. Right, let's get into Showtime. So I'm going to show some of you guys' work. As always, some great stuff's been posted over the last couple of weeks that I've been away, and we're going to show it. So let's see what's going on. Let me get back into this. Okay. Right. Oh, straight in there. Awesome. I didn't have to do anything. That's what I like to see. Cool. Okay. So we've got a lot of stuff to show today, my word. This is stuff going all the way back to the beginning of November, by the looks of things. Let's jump up here. So that Seeker 3D printed a little skull, which is freaking awesome. I don't know how you would even go about this, man. I have no idea how you would 3D print a skull, because there's so many kind of intricate bits inside of it to kind of do. So that's awesome, and great to see that you managed to get it done. I wonder how it layers that up. I see it's not hollow. Okay, that might be why. So you can just kind of go in and then go back out. That's awesome, man. Great stuff. Okay, let's unpin that. All right, unpin. Yep. Next one is Vader, or Hamza, whatever you prefer. You've been creating a little font, haven't you? A little typeface, which is really awesome. This is cool. I really want to eat that skull. I know what you mean, man. It kind of looks like a little sweet or something that you can eat. Imagine if it was coloured, it would even be more kind of like a sweet or something. So yeah, cool little typeface you put together here, man. That is it must be quite tricky to kind of get this looking right in terms of like the shapes and stuff looking correct, even from a distance, for you to be able to recognize the letters. But you've done it really well, man. And I believe you had a bit of help from Frank as well, getting this looking right. Oh, white chocolate. Yeah, that's right, Natural Memory. That's a good point. I didn't think about that. So yeah, so I really like this. I really like this typeface you put together, man. It's really cool. Kind of like futuristic almost. I could imagine this on some sort of futuristic spaceship or something. That'd be pretty damn cool. So yeah, awesome. And then next we got Lena, who has been experimenting with some new things and experimenting with some new artwork. And I really actually like the kind of direction you're kind of going with this kind of like kind of sketchy kind of style, I suppose you could call it. I really think you should explore this further. I've seen a few people to kind of do this style, and I think you're influenced by a couple of them. So yeah, I really like where you're going with this, and definitely keep it up. Keep going for it. Yeah, definitely. Really like, I know this is only like a work in progress, but it'd be interesting to see kind of where you get to with it. Awesome. Let's see. Yes, that Seeker. Also has been playing around with coffee. Looks more like grunge Tank Girl-esque. Yeah, definitely. That reminds me what happened to your ice cream series, Reviver. So basically, that is on hold currently. I have three of them done with another two planned, basically. But I was thinking about releasing them in November. But then I changed my mind because I just started working on this Freddie Mercury piece, which is going to come out next week. And yeah, so they've kind of been put on hold. And depending on where my creativity gets up to, where my creative stuff gets up to, I might release them in December. If I don't release them in December, it'll probably be next summer, potentially. I don't know. I feel like the time has kind of passed a little bit. Like, I was supposed to release them around kind of like August, September, and that kept getting pushed back because I just didn't have the time to do them. And then I worked on a few other projects, like the Iron Maiden one and the Slash one, which were kind of like off-the-cuff projects. So, yeah, man, I mean, it's been put on hold. Might release it in December. We'll see how we go. Otherwise, it'll be next year, probably. We'll see how we go. Maybe in December. So, yeah, anyway, getting back to this. So, Lat Seeker put together this typography. It is real coffee, Natural Mermaid. It is actually made out of real coffee. And I think he posted somewhere a bit further up, he posted the original typography. Maybe I can't see it. Oh, yeah, there we go. Don't know if I can see it. There it is. So, he made this type using a few different typefaces, I believe. And then he hollowed out, I believe, I worked out how he did it. He hollowed out wood, so he actually carved the wood in the shape, and then he put the coffee beans inside the wood, so it kind of like, it fits perfectly, basically, which is a really good way of doing it. And it's really awesome. So it is real coffee, and it's kind of in a groove, I suppose, within the wood, so it's within that. Very, very clever and very well done. Awesome stuff. And then we've got Ghost Monkey, who has been creating another video with his Tooth Fairy logo. I will probably mute the audio because, as we know, as I was telling you guys, the audio came out and ended up having to mute the audio on episode 36 or whatever. But how cool is that? That's really cool. That's a really cool effect. I believe that must be done in particular, I'm pretty sure. Really awesome little effects, and with like the little particles kind of floating in the background. Really nice, man. Really cool. I'm assuming this is all done with After Effects. I'm pretty sure it is. Let's redo that again. It's almost like ice forming in a way. So is that, I think you were saying, is that particular as well, doing that effect where you go kind of like from, it's all particulate. When you go from like that, that's some particulate. Really, that's a really cool effect. I had no idea, because I assumed, because I knew you could do like little particles floating around in particulate, but I didn't know you could like do this kind of transition. That's insane. To be honest, man, I think I actually missed this post when you posted it. I don't think I spotted it when you posted it. So I'm seeing it for the first time, actually. So I'm glad I've gone back and seen it. I don't drink coffee, but I kind of want some now. Yeah, for sure. Yeah, Vader saying he's a tea guy. Well, we're tea drinkers here as well. Natural Mermaid drinks Earl Grey. I drink Tetley. I love tea. I mean, I have to have two teas a day, I think, at least. Otherwise, I can't get anything done. All right, that was Ghost Monkey with some awesome After Effects stuff, man. Let's see. We've now got That Seeker doing some type, who is a proud new owner of a brand new iPad. It's not even a bent iPad like mine. It is a brand new iPad, and he's been coming up with some awesome little type treatments that he's been doing in Procreate. Really nice to see how quickly you're getting on with these, man. I mean, I'm really impressed. It took me at least a week or two to get used to the pencil and get it really like flowing. You've managed to kind of do it in a matter of a day or so, which is awesome. I believe there's another one somewhere here as well. That one we'll show later. So yeah, and this one as well, that's the other one, yeah. Which is really nice as well. Awesome. So, yeah, I mean, that Seeker's coming on leaps and bounds with his typography with the iPad, as we've all seen. So, yeah, keep doing it, man. Really looking forward to seeing where you're getting with these. It'd be really awesome to see how far they can go. What else we got? We got... yeah, Vader with some more typography. Hellbound Heart. This is really awesome. Is this a game? Vader. Or is this like it kind of looks like a band or something, like a horror inspired band. This is a really cool logo, man. Did you come up with the type yourself, or is it a font that you've downloaded or something? It's really cool. I really like it. I'm assuming maybe you downloaded a typeface and then kind of like altered this to kind of look like blood. I'm assuming very kind of horror inspired. And I like your little logo in the corner. It's really cool. I spotted it there. Awesome, man. Cool. Okay, and then we got let's see. Okay, and then Reviver, who's back with us, has been posting stuff. It's the book Hellraiser was based on, wasn't it? Yes, I think you're quite right. Yes. So Reviver's now on Art Station, and he posted this, but I just wanted to kind of like highlight your rocking new Archer, which I think you posted previously. Really cool. And I'm wondering, actually, because you've been away for a bit now, Reviver. I'm meaning to ask you this. How's it been going, and how are you doing with everything? How's your board game going? I know you probably haven't had time to stream and stuff. You've kind of been away from streaming. You're probably working on this. Yeah, I'd love to know how you're getting on with it, man. Like, hope to see you back streaming again at some point soon. And yeah, really like where it's going. I love the new Archer, 100%. It's like miles better than your other one. Miles better, so it's great to see it. Brilliant. Vader, font is a basic one. I edited over it. Ah, okay, man. No problem. Okay, and then we've got... oh, yeah. Lena posted this, which I thought was brilliant. So this is the Chaos Sheriff made from emojis. This is so cool. Like, I don't even know how you got this idea, but it just looks so cool. I love it. I love the guitars that make up the body. It's brilliant. How you got them to all line up and stuff. Must have taken you some time to get them all lined up. 100%. Yeah, for me, this is freaking awesome. I love it. Absolutely love it. Please post more of your little emoji creations, definitely. All right, and then we've got Frank coming in hot with Frank's work. Another one of his from his series, his Anaglyph series, which is freaking awesome. I love the kind of mysteriousness of this. The whole mysteriousness of his whole project that he's put out, and the kind of iconography, it's just absolutely freaking awesome. And I would love to see, probably, I don't know if you're going to stick with this style, Frank. I don't know if you're going to stick with it, but I really like this. It's awesome. Look forward to seeing more of your work soon. And then Proclaim's here. Hey, Proclaim, good to see you, man. Unread messages on there, Phoenix Studios. Okay, cool. No worries. Have you posted something, man? That's awesome. We'll show it. We'll show it in a minute. Let's just finish going through these, and then we'll see yours. Okay, so then Vader. Another cool little bit of artwork Vader put together. This is a vector glove. I'm not sure if you've done this based on a game, or if you're doing this kind of just to practice different techniques, but it's pretty cool. Like to see, interesting how you posted the color scheme. Color schemes, that's pretty awesome, man. That's pretty awesome. All right, and then let's see. What else we got? Oh yeah, Lena Ritchie, who's been posting some awesome pictures from her barber stuff. So we've got God of War. This guy, he does look like Kratos from God of War, to be fair. So you've been kind of doing mock-ups for your barbershop stuff. Great to see some of the stuff you've been doing. And definitely keep posting them. Yeah, I really like these little mashups you're doing where you're trying to bring kind of pop culture into your client work. I think that's really awesome. And then what have we got? We've got Ghost Monkey. Here we go. Woohoo. So Ghost Monkey, you've been creating... I don't even know what this is. Let me read the description. A resin art pour. So have you actually made these items from resin? Like pouring resin or something? That's pretty insane, man. Like, I don't know how... I have no idea how you've gone about this. That's insane. Absolutely insane. Really cool, man. Digging it, 100%. Yeah, and this is kind of like a... Is it like just like different bits of artwork or something? I don't know. I've never seen anything like this. This is quite interesting. Yeah, would be great if you were... Sorry, stream lagging, missing every other word here. Ah, bollocks. Sorry, I swore. My bad. See, I'm going to drop frames, man. Seems to be okay for me. It's like it's made from space. Yeah, 100%. Like, I absolutely love the texture you've put in this ghost monkey. It's absolutely awesome. Great to see. I don't know how you've actually made it, but it's freaking awesome. Then Mr. Triple. We've got tons to go through today, guys, because I've been away for a week or so. So this is Mr. Triple's latest effort, which he posted on Instagram, which is all to do with Reclamation Day 76, which is, what's it called, Fallout 76. And so he posted this as a little tribute towards it, which is awesome. I haven't played any of the Fallout games personally. I don't really know. I understand you're in a shelter and you have to kind of like get away from things or salvage things. That's all I know about it. But I know it's from Bethesda, is it? Bethesda, who do Oblivion. So I know Oblivion, so that's cool. Alcohol, ink, and epoxy resin. That's awesome, man. That's great. That's great stuff. And then we've got... what have we got? I think we've got something else. Oh, yes, we've got Create by That Seeker. Also awesome. Another lovely piece of typography from That Seeker. Looking forward to seeing what else you make, man. I don't think you're in the stream today. But hey, if you watch this, keep at it. It's looking cool. And looking forward to seeing what else you come up with. I don't know what Proclaim's saying. He's saying there's an unread message on there. An unread message. I mean the server. I have no idea. Can't see anything. Apart from That Seeker posting some process stuff. Don't see any kind of unread messages. I have no idea what Proclaim's talking about. I can't see anything. No unread messages that I can see, guys. Please tell me if I've missed something. I don't think I've missed anybody's work because I can't see any on there. Okay. No worries. So, yeah, that was Showtime today, guys. Great seeing your work. Some awesome work, as always, that you guys post. Are really inspiring. Keep posting, man. Love to see what you guys are working on week. So, so that's kind of our lineup for today. Great to see everything that you guys have been working on. And, yeah, great to see what you got. Oh, I see. I think I see what Proclaim is talking about now. He's saying all the unread messages on the servers. Oh, I see what he means. I finally got what he meant. Yeah, I've got. I mean, there's loads of stuff that I haven't read. I've joined too many Discords, is my problem. Too many of them, and I barely use any of them now. I've got so many. I barely use any of them now, apart from Signal Noise and my own. I just don't have time to keep up with everything. All right, so back to our lineup. We'll just do a bit of an encore now, guys, and then we will kind of finish up for the day. And today I think what I'll do is I will finish with a bit of hair rock. I think I'm feeling like a bit of hair rock, so I'm actually going to put the Wig of Destiny on right now. No one needs to redeem it. The Wig of Destiny is going on. I haven't used this for a while. So let's just do a bit of a rock out now, because this will be quite fun. Okay, great community. Yeah, man, that's exactly the whole point of this. Got it, hit the nail right on the head, man. It's like bringing all these creatives together, everybody together, helping each other and stuff. That's what it's all about. All right, so I get my camera on. Yeah, Wig of Destiny, rock on. A bit of rock and roll. So let's do our encore now. Okay. Let me get my tone on. Yeah. Nice. Let's do our encore for today, guys. I usually go and put the other camera on, but I've turned it off, so. Let's just rock out a bit. We'll be right back. So that's our little encore for today. Awesome. Okay, dueling banjos. Sorry, I only have one banjo and one set of arms. And that's all I need. So yeah, so that's our little encore for today. A fun little show after a 2-week break. It's been cool to hang out with you guys again. Another mascot name suggestion is Shreddy. That's a good name, man. I like it. When did you first pick up the guitar? Now that is a very good question, Vader, actually. When did I first pick up the guitar? Wow, now I feel old thinking about it. I think the first time I picked up a guitar, I was 16. So that would be 20 years ago. Now I feel old. Oh, dude, I feel really old now. I mean, I've played on and off probably... Yeah, 20 years. Jesus, bloody hell. I can't believe that's that long now. Jeez. Yeah, I think it was 16, 17 I started playing guitar on acoustic. First song I ever learned was Come As You Are by Nirvana because it was so simple. It was just like, you know, dun, 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 dun. Whatever. That's how I used to play it. I used to play it with my fingers because I thought it was like a bass or whatever, but it wasn't. And I only knew the little riff at the beginning. I didn't know the rest of the rhythm parts. so that answers your question, man. Let's think. You're 16 right now. Fair enough, man. No worries. You've got plenty of time to learn. Plenty of time. Loads of time. Awesome. So that's our show for today, guys. We will be back next week we will be back on a slightly different time next week, based on what I was talking to you guys earlier about. So we'll be back on Thursday next week at 8 p.m., a slightly different time, so it's an hour later than today, and one day different. And the reason for this, as I was saying on the Discord, is we're going to try and get Frank on the stream. Bless him, because he finds it very hard to tune in and stuff, and really want Frank to be able to tune in. I know a few people can't make it next week. That's no worries. Totally get it. Totally understand. But we're going to be testing this new time and see how it goes. Let's just see how we get on. All right, gang. So we're moving to Australia. Yeah, well, I think it's 7 a.m. Frank's time. So he said he's going to do his best to get up. But if he doesn't make it, he might be like a little bit late. So that's cool. He might join like after half an hour or something, or 45 minutes. No worries. So yeah, and hopefully everybody can tune in. As we always do. There's no problem. Right. I'll see you guys on the Discord. I'm wishing you all a very good rest of the week. Wishing you all the best for this week. And yeah, rock on.